السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In our house in Awqaf city, on our villa there, there was a tenant in the ground floor. Her name was Fatima Salim, and she was giving the impression that this villa belonged to her before we came to live in the house, and the relationship between her and us was not very good, to a point that one day actually they were actually shouting and screaming at all of us. And not only from downstairs, but they went to their friends in the house opposite our house, and they went to the balcony to swear at us. And what my father did, rahmatullah alayhi, or my mother did, rahmatullah alayhim, they asked us to close all the windows, do not respond to all of them, and wait till they finish what they are doing. This was the relationship between us and the tenant. Could not be able to go to the garden. We are the landlord, but we could not be able to go to the garden there because the garden was a part of the ground floor rent. And she has quite a few girls and two boys, and the youngest boy was, his name was Mahmoud, and he had a heart condition. And we used to play football together in the street. And have nothing to do with the quarrel between, or the misunderstanding or differences between all of us. And Mahmoud was a very nice young man, nearly at my age. And once upon a time, all of a sudden, on one day, we heard screaming, shouting, crying, actually from the ground floor. And we rushed downstairs to see what happened to our neighbor, the lady, and we discovered that her son Mahmoud died with asphyxia and suffocation because of his heart condition. At that time, there was no, the gas pipes were not actually connected to the houses. Used to use the kerosene heater to heat the water there in the bathroom, and the smoke came out and suffocated him because of his heart condition. And he died maybe at the age of 16 at that time. Maybe he was 1 year older than me, or at the same age, whatever it is. The woman who actually before that was like an iron lady, very strong character, and was broken. And she became somebody totally different. And she hated the flat, and she hated the house, and she wanted to leave the building, not to be sitting and staying in a place where her young, beautiful boy or son died there. And we were actually trying to comfort her through ourselves and our neighbors. But one day we found that her elder son came to my father and spoke to him that about the wish of his mother to leave the house because she cannot, to leave the flat, because she cannot tolerate stay anymore after the death of her young son. And they were claiming, asking us for some money, to leave the house. Without any hesitation, we did not negotiate with them anywhere, because my father and my mother looked at her of the her condition, her psychological and moral condition, as well as at that time you don't have to negotiate and to try to cut corners. And I think the amount of money at the time was either 300 pounds or 400 pounds, and I don't think we had the money in ourselves, but actually we might have borrowed it from some of the relatives. And they give her the money and they blessed her departure, and she went to live in one of the flats in the building owned by her late husband. Here, young men and women, you have to know that your parents, see the response of my father and my mother of closing the windows when somebody was shouting at you, throwing stones at you. We see the neighbor, neighbor as always neighbor. Sometimes we disagree and tomorrow we'll agree on something, but the closest one to you is your neighbor. And the Prophet ﷺ was trying to advise us to be good to our neighbor. Plus, at the time of a weak neighbor in the condition like this, you don't cut corner with them, you don't put pressure on them, give them what they need because they need it, not because it's too much or too little, but actually realize their condition and deal with it as a doctor or as a friend or as a colleague or as a social worker. جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.